Hello everyone. Today we'll discuss export subsidies in a large country and the losses that results from that subsidy. What is a subsidy? Well, it might be a payment by the government to a firm or an individual that ships a good. But this particular subsidy is given only for exporting the good. It is not given to the producer if the producer sells the product at home in the domestic market. So what happens as a result of an export subsidy? Now, if the price of the product was $10, and this was the world price, it was $10 in the rest of the world, or in the foreign country, as well as in the domestic country, assuming that there is free trade. Now, as soon as the export subsidy is given in this country, the exporter, when decides to export the good, gets a subsidy, let's say $2. So when the producer tries to export the good, he gets a price of $12. But if he decides to sell in the domestic market, he only gets the price $10. So there's a distinction between export subsidy and production subsidy. The export subsidy is only given if the product is exported to the international market. Now, what is this going to do? Well, producers would then have an incentive to export the good rather than sell it in the domestic market. So the supply of exports increases at the expense of domestic supply. First of all, let's see what happens in the world market. Well, suppose this was our demand and supply in the world market, and equilibrium price would be PW, the world price. As soon as a large country is given an export subsidy, there's an increase in exports to the rest of the world. And it's going to have an effect on the prices because the exporting country is a large country and has a large share of the export market. So there's an increase in export supply. Supply has increased. Now what that does is it pushes down the world prices to PW star. The new equilibrium point is at 2. So an export subsidy by a large country really pushes down the world prices. We want to know what happens within the country that's giving the export subsidy. Right? So it's the exporting country. Let's just review. PW is the world price. S, we're going to think of as subsidy. PW star is a new world price after the subsidy is given. PD is the domestic price after the subsidy is given. Right? The exporting country is open to free trade, so it takes PW as the world price. Then the government comes in and gives export subsidy. What happens in the international market is that the world prices fall. Price drop to PW star. All right. So now PW star is the new world price. What happens at home? Well, at home, producers, if they export the good, they get PW star plus the amount of the subsidy. But if they sell it in the domestic market, they only get PW star. So they won't sell in the domestic market unless the prices in the domestic market increases to what they get if they export the good. So the domestic prices has to rise by the amount of the subsidy. So the domestic price would be PW star plus subsidy, which is PD. All right. So this is the new domestic price, and this is the amount of exports. As you can see, exports has increased. Now, the next step is to see what happens to the welfare. What is the change in producer surplus? Well, it's the area above the supply function and below the equilibrium price. So the price that the producers used to face was PW. Now it has increased to PD. So the change in producer surplus is A plus B plus C. That's the producer's gain. What is the consumer's loss? It's A plus B, the area below the demand function between the price change. What about the cost of the export subsidy? Well, that's equal to the amount of exports multiplied by the amount of subsidy, because this is a unit subsidy, and that will give you the cost of subsidy, right? So it's the amount of exports which is given by this into the amount of subsidy which is given by this. So it's really this area here, right? So the cost of the government subsidy is B plus C plus D, E, F, and G. Now, that few things that have happened here. One is that the world prices fell. If you think about the large countries terms of trade, the terms of trade have declined. Now, how are terms of trade defined? Well, it's price of exports over price of imports, right? Now, by giving an export subsidy, the large country has decreased the price of exports. So now it gets a lower price in the world market for the good that it exports. So this decline is really the terms of trade loss. The other thing that has happened is that there has been a change in the consumption and production of this good. Right? The production has increased, and it has increased by this much, and the consumption has declined. So we have an efficiency loss equal to B. This is really the consumption distortion. D is the efficiency loss because of production distortion. And the terms of trade loss is your EFG. So you see, there has been a decrease in the price of exports. So now this level of exports gets a lower price. Instead of PW, it gets PW star. So this is your terms of trade loss. So what we really see is that when a large country gives export subsidy, there's a loss to the country, and this loss is measured by B plus D plus E plus F plus G. So that's a large amount of loss as a result of export subsidy. So in conclusion, an export subsidy raises the prices in the exporting country. It lowers the prices in the rest of the world, or you can refer to that as the importing country or the foreign country. It worsens the terms of trade for the exporting country, right? Because the price of exports has fallen. The cost of this subsidy is much higher than the benefits, so it's always welfare reducing for the country as a whole.